What is going on, guys? Thank you so much for checking out another video from me here on YouTube. Today I'm just going to be doing some stuff with the bike. It's like 5:30, yeah, 5:29. It's Monday night. I moved my truck just a little bit forward. It's obviously the garage is open, but just to get myself a little bit more room back here, I'm going to take my bike out. So what I'm going to be doing today, I'm going to take off the decals for the number plates, get those ready. My graphics have been printed. They're ready. Wednesday night, I'm actually going to go down to FAF Graphics, where I got the graphics. That's faafgraphics.com if you're interested. And I'm going to have them install the graphics so I don't ruin them. So I'm going to take off these ones. And then I think I'm just going to give the bath like a... essentially like a sponge, give the bike like a sponge bath. I'm gonna, you know, get some soap and water and the Purple Power and some Brillo pad and just kind of give it a bath right here, because I don't want to load it up and take it to the power washer. But we'll see. I'm gonna do that, and then if it still needs some more washing before Wednesday, then I'll do that. But also gonna be taking off the current pipe that's on it, because I did order that new Yoshimura pipe. It's not here yet because I ordered it yesterday, but hopefully, I know there's Thanksgiving in the US, of course, on this Thursday. Hopefully I'll have the pipe by Saturday, have it for the weekend, I don't know. But I do, of course, have the stock pipe over here. Blow dryer is what we're gonna be using for the graphics, that's why that's down here. But I do have the stock pipe, so if all else fails, I could put that on, but hopefully that's not the case. So got everything here, got my tools, got the blow dryer, got the bike. We're gonna move it on out and get crack-a-lackin' on this.
I hope you find what you've been looking.
So I'm going to go ahead and give the bike essentially a sponge bath, like I said. So right here, I have just normal water. This is an old 409 bottle. I really like these bottles. So it's just normal water. Got some rags, paper towels, of course. The Brillo SOS whatever pad. Some rubbing alcohol, WD-40. These will help. Like, this might be able to take off some of this stickiness here. And the WD-40 kind of does the same. I've already tried the WD-40 on it already. Didn't do as good as I would have liked. But so we'll try. We'll figure something out. And then this is just diluted Purple Power, which is a cleaning agent that you can get at like an auto parts store or Walmart, probably, even with the old inverted sticker. But we're gonna go ahead, we'll get this all cleaned up, stuff like this, scuff marks. We'll just get all the, pretty much everywhere that new graphics are gonna go is what I'm gonna focus on. I'll probably hit the seat since I'm here. But everywhere that new graphics are gonna be sticking to, I'll clean up real nice. Like, this side's actually way worse than the other side, but the front number plate looks like it's hardly ever even been touched. It's amazing, but we'll get the front fender and everything. So, and actually, I guess I need to do these too. I totally forgot about those, but we'll get those off as well.
I'm thinking out loud before we draw a crowd. Reel it in, take it easy. There's no need to scream and shout.
Alright guys, so I got these stickers off too. I don't think I'm gonna like hand wash these. I'm looking at the bike, thinking about it. I will take it to the car wash before I run it down to FAF to get the graphics on, just because I didn't wash it after riding, so it's still very muddy like up underneath, and I don't want them working with the bike in those conditions. I don't know exactly how their shop is, but I don't want to track mud into it, and why show up with a dirty bike? So I'm not gonna do like a full wash when I go to the car wash. But I'll just like power wash the undersides, you know, get all that grime out of there. It's not like there's a ton of mud, but like I don't want that on their workspace. So we'll go ahead and do that. But that about wraps it up for the bike wash part and graphics part. So obviously the graphics came off nice and simple. Got them looking pretty good a little bit up here. I could probably hit a little bit more. This is the part I'm kind of worried about. It just kind of has a little bit of, like you can see, you can scrape it off of there, but I can't like wash it off with alcohol or WD-40 or anything. I'm having trouble getting that off of both sides. You probably can't see it over here as much because it's so dark, but maybe they'll have a tip when I go down there or something. But overall, looking pretty good. So now I'm gonna go ahead and take off the muffler. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Now I'm debating with myself, because if I wanna take it to the car wash, I don't want an open pipe up here. So you know what, I'm actually gonna leave this on for today so I can wash it like that. But I think I am gonna take up air filter. I'll wash that tonight and then I'll let it dry overnight, oil it back up tomorrow and put her on in. So we'll go ahead and do that. I'm gonna stop and interject here real quick. Just because you do something like this a different way doesn't mean the other way is wrong. I've used different oil or air filter cleaners before, and what works best for me is just the tried and true gasoline method. Some people say, you know, it can break down the make of the air filter, and you could be right, but I haven't had an issue. It cleans it the best way that I've found out of any way I've tried. It works really well. I like it a lot. This is how I do my air filter. I mean, maybe you'll say, you know, you're not supposed to squeeze it. You know, whatever. That's how I do mine. It seems to work all right. So I just want to throw that in. Just because you do it a different way doesn't mean someone else does it wrong. You know, just because you guys do it two different ways. As the old saying goes, there's more than one way to skin a cat, right? But if you do use something like gas, make sure that you're disposing of this properly. Don't go throw it down the drain, or don't go pour it on the sidewalk or something, you know. Dispose of it properly. So I have a container that I put this kind of stuff in, so I'll be doing that when I'm finished up here. But I just wanted to throw that in. I'm sure you probably do yours a different way. This is how I do mine. It works for me. Boom. Today. Like I said, I wanted to take off the muffler, but then thinking about, oh, I should go to the wash, I should leave the muffler on so then I can stick the FMF plug in the back of it and not get water down into my engine. So leaving the pipe on for now. Probably take this to the car wash tomorrow night. I could even run and do it now, but I don't think I want to do that. I don't know. But do that, and then I'll take the muffler off. I don't know, but Wednesday is the day that it's going to be going down to FAF graphics, and we're actually going to be installing the graphics on it. I'm not, but one of the guys down there is actually going to do it. So I'll obviously record that, get you guys up to date on that, but next time you see it, it'll be all tricked out. At least that's the plan. Of course, Thanksgiving is this week, Thursday. I don't know what my plans are that riding. It ends up, turns out that my parents are going to be back actually for this weekend. So maybe one of these days I'll just go hit the track with my dad. And if I get the new pipe in time, maybe I'll just go out to Aztec and just give her the old run around there, try it out for the first time. But that's what's going on, guys. Thanks for tuning in. I hope you enjoyed this video. I'm just going to, actually, I'm going to load up the bike in the back of the truck, so tomorrow when I do want to go wash it, it's already all loaded up and I don't have to load it and then go. But yeah, so that's going to be it, you guys. So that's how I do graphics, take them off. That's how I do my air filter. It's over there drying. After I park the truck, I'll hang it up from the garage door, like right over here, so it's just hang drying. And then once it's all the way dried, then obviously I'll be putting some, well, I'm not gonna put this on it, it's in my truck, some air filter oil, just some Bel-Ray air filter oil, put that on it, and toss her back in, and we'll be good to go. So as always, you guys, until next time, take it easy. If it's easy, take it twice. Talk to you later. I swear, there's more graphics on the bike than I always remember. So for those of you who noticed, I'm taking these off too, because I do have new ones of these. So I'm going to go ahead and take those off now. I totally forgot about them until I took a picture, and then I was like, oh wait, those need to come off. So taking those off now.